Hare Krishna. All of us will face suffering in life sooner or later. And of course, we try to make various arrangements so that we have medical insurance, so that we have financial security. And through that, we try to prepare for whatever sufferings we might face in life. But still, we can't eliminate suffering. What we can, however, do is cultivate a purpose that makes our life meaningful and our suffering bearable. So, what does that mean? That means that ultimately the arrows of suffering are going to hit us. And we might try to dodge them. If our life is focused simply on dodging those arrows, then eventually those arrows will be undodgeable. And because we spend our whole life trying to avoid suffering, we didn't do anything constructive except avoid suffering. And we couldn't avoid suffering also. So we'll feel doubly frustrated, because our life went waste and we couldn't even succeed in avoiding suffering. But instead, if we cultivate a purpose, then what will happen is, if we are to do something worthwhile in our life, say if a soldier is fighting a war where there are brutal terrorists who are out to slaughter innocent people, and that soldier has a purpose, and even if there is suffering, that suffering becomes a little more bearable. Now, all of us can be agents of change for ourselves and for the world around us. We can, by our consciousness directed constructively, use our talents and resources to make a positive difference. Even if it is small or it is big, that doesn't matter so much. What matters is that we can make a difference. So when we have that purpose, okay, this is what my strengths are, this is what my interests are, and this is what I can do with these, say, then suppose somebody is a doctor and they have got a medicine which can cure people. Then even if they have to go through distant areas where traveling is inconvenient, but if they know that I can help people, I can make a difference in people's lives, then that suffering of going through all that travel becomes much more bearable. So if somebody is going just for sightseeing, then every inconvenience becomes hugely irritating, because they are going for pleasure, and if pleasure doesn't come, you feel, what is the point? Why did I travel? But if you are going for some meaningful purpose, to say, deliver some medicine which is going to save people's lives, then even if we have to go through some trouble, yes, this trouble is worth it, because others who are suffering far more are going to be saved from that trouble by what I can deliver to them. So we need to cultivate a purpose. All of us have been given some talent, some abilities by the divine, by Krishna. The Bhagavad-Gita explains that we are all parts of Krishna and we are all meant to serve him. And serve him means that just as Arjun used his abilities in Krishna's service, we are also meant to use our abilities to serve him in various areas of life. When we do that, then even amidst distress, our purpose will see us through. The purpose will make the suffering we have to go through worthwhile, bearable, because our life will be fruitful. So this vision of a purpose of contribution as a part of the vision of the whole to help the other parts, it was this vision that energized Arjun. And that's why that same Arjun who was disheartened and devastated by the distress surrounding him when he confronted the prospect of the war, that Arjun became wholehearted by the end of the Bhagavad Gita. And he, in readiness to answer the call of duty, even amidst distress, he declared, Nashto moha smate labdha tvat prasadan mayachuta sthitosmi gata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. So similarly, by cultivating a purpose to contribute in a mood of service to the divine, we can make our life meaningful and our suffering bearable. Thank you. Hare Krishna.